Well, hey, it's Alora from Firebird Summit, and it is mid-March 2020. We are in the middle of a very unusual experience globally, but definitely in the U.S. when it comes to COVID-19 and the sudden kind of widespread expectation that as many people as possible work from home. It's an interesting thing for me to suddenly find myself being pinged by a lot of people who are suddenly in a scramble as to how to manage teams remotely. As someone who has done that for more than a decade, it's not something I ever intended to become an expert in, but at the moment, it's definitely getting me on people's radar that I hadn't expected. My email this morning has kind of exploded. So I wanted to start with a short video on a couple of quick things that I think are super helpful for managers who are suddenly finding themselves trying to manage their teams remotely. Now, my assumption here is that you have a team that is typically in the same place on a daily basis, and suddenly, for whether it's this reason or some other reason, are suddenly now working from home or working from a remote location of some kind, and now all of a sudden you're trying to adapt your management skills and process to trying to keep tabs on how things are moving when you can't have actual face-to-face conversations. So, again, I've been doing remote team management since about 2010, and it takes some getting used to. There are pros and cons, like with all things, but it's not impossible. What I would say more than anything else is be patient during any transition window, particularly if this only turns out to be for a couple of weeks. You're probably going to spend most of those weeks kind of struggling back and forth. But the goal is definitely to get to a place where this is as manageable as possible, because the odds are this is not going to be the last time we do this. So a couple of really quick tips that I will start with. The first one is establish your routine with your team. This is going to be super important going forward. Now, a lot of times we don't think about it, but when we're all in the office together, we do have routines. A lot of them are informal. It could be, you know, dropping my stuff at my desk before going and getting a cup of coffee, or doing a quick, you know, kind of drive-by through my department to check in on people or see who's in already and who's not. Whatever your routine is, jot down a couple of notes for yourself so you can understand what it is that you normally do to get your day started at the office, and then figure out how many of those things will translate to a virtual version versus how many really won't. Some of them actually really will, and you'll want to take advantage of those that can, because it's going to help both you and your team feel as normal as possible in this time of a lot of abnormality. So the second one is space. Now, this is super hard, especially when you're dealing with people who live in apartments and really small living situations that have never had to accommodate dedicated space. But to whatever extent possible, both you as a manager and your team members need to carve out a space that they can dedicate to work where they can focus. Now, this is going to be especially important because so many of your employees have kids who have school that's been canceled. Their spouses are also not able to work in their offices and are also at home. So in many cases, you're going to have people who are suddenly finding themselves in very cramped quarters with a lot of noise and a lot of chaos and a little bit too much pent up energy and frustration and possibly anxiety. So you definitely want to encourage wherever possible for them to find a dedicated space to be able to focus on work. When a dedicated space is not necessarily possible, opt for headphones. Headphones and some, you know, background canceling music, classical jazz, something, you know, non-verbal is usually the best way to help drown out some background noise and help keep people focused. So again, encourage that as much as possible and do it for yourself. The third item is really try to remember to act like you would as much as possible in the office. That means get dressed, take a shower, get dressed, go through your morning routine. Don't work in your pajamas. Don't spend your day on Facebook unless you do that already. Don't watch TV all day. For starters, right now, what's on TV all day is going to stress you out more than anything else, and it's not necessarily going to give you new, valuable, or useful information. So try to keep that in mind. You need to remember that it's very chaotic right now, and that both you and your team need to carve out brain space to focus. So act like you would during a normal day at the office. That means if you're gonna run errands, try to run them at lunch. If whatever you need to do, try to behave and run your day the same way you would if you were going into the office and leaving at the end of the day. The fourth is one that I really, really strongly encourage, and that is use video chat as much as possible. For those of us who are used to being in offices, it is sometimes extremely difficult to start understanding just how much of the message we're getting from our colleagues is actually nonverbal in nature. And so again, in a time of enormous stress like this, or in a time when you've got a lot of transition and people who haven't historically worked from home suddenly trying to work from home, you really want to make sure you're doing as much as you can to cultivate that degree of normalcy, but also those connections. And using video instead of exclusively relying on voice or instant message or email is a really useful way to help. And I would recommend doing a couple of times per day with your team, particularly in the beginning, as everybody's getting the hang of everything. Finally, you know, in tech, we have something called scrums, and they're daily stand-up meetings, literally because you're supposed to be standing. They're supposed to be 15 minutes, and it's a quick, what did I do today? What am I going to do tomorrow? What are the obstacles in my way? That is fundamentally a very useful way to help re-engage and reconnect your team in a time of chaos and confusion and discombobulation because of this kind of disruption. So I would strongly recommend to managers that if you can do a daily stand-up, either first thing in the morning or at the end of the day, often the best, to be able to get your team together on a video call and spend no more than 15 minutes going through everybody and answering those questions. What did I get done today? What am I going to get done tomorrow? And what is in my way that I need help getting obstacles cleared? That's a good way to help make sure that people are staying in touch with each other, helping each other out, which is going to be paramount to keeping as much as possible feeling normal. But also it'll help you as a manager stay very, very clear on what it is your team is doing and where they actually do need you to dig in and focus. So I'm sure that there are going to be other things that come up over the next few weeks as we continue to watch this whole exercise unfurl. I might pop in and do a couple more videos. More than anything else, though, I will say working from home when you're not used to it can sound super sexy and appealing. And for years, I have listened to people say, oh, you're so lucky you get to work from home. While in the back of my mind, I've always thought, ugh, hate it. I would never do it if I didn't have to. But the truth is, I have had to learn to do it. The nature of the work that I've done for the past decade has demanded it. And so it is something that you can learn. It can be a fairly steep learning curve, though, for people who are not naturally predisposed to it. And so be patient with both yourself and your team, and you'll find it goes a lot better. Also, remember, people who are used to going into the office every day will often be used to a certain degree of social interaction that they get from that. Having them work from home, especially if they're somebody who might live alone and not actually have a lot of social interaction as a result, really could start to feel isolated quickly. So my advice to managers for that is check in, try to establish as much of an open door policy as you can remotely, and make sure that you're constantly touching base with your team to understand what it is that is working for them about this arrangement, what they need, and where they're starting to struggle. So with that, I hope you have as safe and productive a week as possible, given the very strange circumstances we find ourselves in. And if you have any questions or need any other tips, let me know. And do plenty of videos on this topic for a while. So have a great week, and I will talk to you on Wednesday when Lawrence and I interview my friend Shana Story on this week's episode of Grow or Die. Take care.